more features than this. Another new feature that we want to add in our application is like the street access accelerometers and the rumble. We also want to use two way mode together to do something. So what we do in the second application is to use two remote to play a classical pong game. In the game, each remote represent one pedal. And the difference of this application to the mouse application is now we do not have a template. We need to combine V programming, OpenGL programming, and C# programming together to create this this program. And how we implement the V-mode feature in the game, we use the accelerometer to rotate the camera angle of the game, so it makes the game looks 3D. And we use the rumble to create a feedback mechanism, so every time when your pedal hits the wall, it will turn on the rumble and let you know. And the L camera and the buttons are related to the game logic. We use them to updating the position of the ball, the pedal, and to computing the collision of the ball, and to updating the score bar. And we also use two remotes to do some simple gesture recognition. We can use two remotes to zoom in and zoom out the game scene. Okay, and this is our first application result. The right picture is a human-computer interface of the V-mouse, and in the picture you can find the cursor and which button you are pressed, and we use this to drag the small cube and to rotate it and zoom in, zoom out, and move it. And we also test multiple existing wall applications in the hyperspace. We test the world map, the weather forecast, and a lot of photo views, and it works well. And for the second application, the game, we test it on the head node. Today we bring you a PC version Pong game. It is almost the same as what you can see on the hyperspace. Okay, so now I will show you. Okay, now it looks like 2D, but now you can use one remote to rotate along Z-axis and along X-axis. Thus, you can put the game from any angle you like, and now you can stay like play the game like this way. And what else you can do? You can zoom in and zoom out to see. Okay. So. In conclusion, we realized the requirement of to do some interactive control of 2D and 3D applications running on the hyperspace of the portal. And the meaning of our objective to give an inspiration of the hyperspace team that the V-mode can work as a generative 3D input device, and you can use V-mode to do some more complex real-time control than what we have done in this project. And you can use up to four remotes to do some more complex gesture recognition. So the possibility of the use of the remote are endless. Thank you. Questions?
Suppose I'm someone that has developed an application for the hyperspace display, and I hear that I can use Wiimote as my interface. What's the process I have to go through to make use of the Wiimote in an application that I've coded separately?
Oh, you mean you want to use any another kind of external input a device to control the.
I have an application. I let's say I designed it for for mouse or keyboard or like that, and now I want to use the Wiimote.
Okay.
What do I have to do?
I will analyze your applications. In which step you use a keyboard or mouse, and in the code, what I need to adjust include the V library, and convert your code about keyboard or mouse move or press to Wiimote cursor move and Wiimote button press or release. And I think if your application does work on the Hyperspace, and simply by converting the code, the new application will also work.
Okay, but am I hearing correctly? I'm going to have to recompile my application.
Yeah, you need to recompile your application.
Okay, thanks again.